Hello everyone, I am Tripta Singhal from the Career Classes. In this video, we'll learn how to solve the equations by the substitution method. From the chapter 3, pair of linear equations in two variable from unit 2, algebra. Let's start exercise 3.3, question 1, substitution method. Okay, so in this question, we have 4 or 6 sub questions. So out of them, we solve some of them. Okay, so let's check out the second one. S minus t is equals to 3. We have the two equations given here in any form. S by 3 plus t by 2 is equals to 6. First of all, we have to convert the equations in our general formula. That means general formula for the equations in two variable. That means ax plus by plus c1 is equals to 0 and a2x plus b2y plus c2 is equals to 0. That means our constant must be here. Okay. Therefore, this is already in our general form. In this substitution method, the constant may be from in LHS side or RHS side. But this equation is not in our general form. So convert it in our general form by taking the LCM, or we can say the cross multiplication method. That means 2 multiplied by s and 3 multiplied by 2. So what we have here, 2s plus 3t whole divided by 6 is equals to 6. And this goes 6 goes to multiply with this 6. So finally we have our equation as 2s plus 3t is equals to 36. So this is our equation number 2 and first equation number 1. Now solve by substitution method. So in that matter, as per our my previous video, you can see how we solve the substitution method, the step by step. But in this video, I show you how to solve. Okay, first of all, from any of equation, you can find the value of a one variable. From any of equation, you can find the value of one variable, and then the value of that variable you can put the rest in the rest equation. So you get the value of the another variable. So how can we solve it? Let's start. So by substitution method. From equation 1, s minus t is equals to 3. This is our first equation. So I can feel that this in from this equation, I can find the value of a variable more easily than the second equation. So therefore, s is equals to 3 plus t. So I can find the value of one variable in the terms of a second variable. So when we put, now we put the value of s, or we can give equation star, the value of star in equation 2, the remaining equation, okay, in the equations 2. So the equation becomes in a one variable only. As we can see, the equation is in two variables, that's why we can't solve it. So 2s plus 3t is equals to 36. This is our second equation. Okay, now we put the value of s is equals to in the remaining equation, that means second equation. So what we have, so s is equals to 3 plus t plus 3t is equals to 36. So finally our second equation is converted fully in a one variable, that is t. Okay, now expand it. 6 plus 2t plus 3t is equals to 36. Therefore, 5t is equals to 36 minus 6, that is 30. And therefore, t is equals to 30 by 5, that is 6. So we have finally, we have the value of a one variable, t is equals to 6. Just put this value in our equation star. So you get the value of the another variable. Therefore, from equation star, what is that? S is equals to 3 plus t. Therefore, we get s is equals to 3 plus, well, value of the t is equals to 6. Just put it in the equation star. So you get 3 plus 6 is equals to 9. So we have the value of our both variables t and s is s is equals to 9 and t is equals to 6. The variable may be x, y, u, v, z, they can any from the a to z. So we basically we have to find the values of that variables only. Let's check out the some another we can solve the fourth one. 0.2x plus 0.3y is equals to 1.3, and second equation is 0.4x plus 0.5y is equals to 2.3, as you given in your textbook. Okay, so what you did first here, just look at these equations, all are in the fraction, all are in the form of a fraction, in the decimal form. Now so we can convert it in our regular form, that's why we can multiply both the sides of the equation 1 and equation 2 by 10. So we can convert them in our general formula, in our regular formula. So by multiplying with 10 on both the sides, so what we have from equation 1 is, if we multiply 0.2 by 2 0.2 by 10, then we have only 2x, 3y is equals to 13. So this is our equation 1. And what about second? So 0.4, that becomes 4 only. 4x plus 5y is equals to 23. So this is our equation 2. This is as simple as that. We can convert our equations in our general formula, or like this, ax plus by is equals to minus c1, because this is a substitution method. So I prefer that our c constants are on the RHS sides. That's why we can find the easily the values of variables. Okay, so now from this, out of these two equations, you can choose any of your equations for finding the value of one variable. Let's see, I take first equation only. So 2x is equals to 13 minus 13y. 2x is equals to 13 minus, sorry, 3y. And therefore, x is equals to 13 minus 3y by 2. This is our equation number star. Just give as equation number star. Now, put this value of x in which equation? Yes, my friends, in equation 2, the remaining one. So let's put it. So from equation 2, 4 into x is 13 minus 3y divide by 2 plus 5y is equals to 23. You can choose any of your equation, any of your favorite equations. So first we see here 2 and 4, so we cut it out. 4 2s are 2, 2s are 4, 13 2s are 26 minus 6y plus 5y is equals to 23. Therefore, minus 6y plus 5y minus 1, that means I can write minus y only, and 23 here, 26 goes here on RHS side because the constant is here. Please make sure the variables are on a one side and the constant are on a other side. So minus y is equals to 23 minus 26, that is minus 3. Therefore, if both the side we have a minus, then it's cut it out. So y is equals to 3. So we have finally the value of our one variable. Now what to do? If we get the value of one variable, just put it in the equation star. So what from the equation star, we have x is equals to 13 minus 3, y is 3 divide by 2. So we have 13 minus 9, that is 4, 4 and divide by 2. So x is equals to 2. Finally, we have our values of the two variables. So this is all about our substitution method. You can ask me any of your doubts in a comment box, so we can solve in our next video. Thank you for watching.